top. Put your hands up. Oh, I stop.
Turn me up, Joe.
Rockstar lifestyle, might not make. Put prescription drugs on my tongue, I had to take. Keep my secrets deep down inside.
Yo, what's good, YouTube? It's Mr. Mom with another video. Today's video, hold on, don't let me start off the video like that. How was y'all day, y'all? Tell me in the comment section how your day went, how was school, how was work, when you watching this video, what you doing right now, how was your day, bro? But back to the video, we're gonna be talking about why is your jump shot broke? The reason why your jump shot is not hitting like it's supposed to, the reason you're not getting green lights. Why I'm not getting green lights, why is this jump shot not working? So I'm gonna tell you ways and the reasons why your jump shot is not working, how to enhance your green lights of making shots with a jump shot that you've been using. So, as you look at these clips, I'm showing you part clips right here, but I will show you some more clips of me at rec. This jump shot I'm using is my mid-career jump shot. My mid-career jump shot is my NBA 2K17 jump shot, if you did not know that. So, this jump shot is a jump shot you'll only use in mid-career in park, but in the rec center gameplay, I have a park jump shot that works in park and rec. The reason is that because in the latency and the when you play rec and pro-am, it's way slower than park. But this jump shot works for both. So I'm not even gonna talk about my jump shot right now. It's about your jump shot. So we're gonna be talking about your jump shot, why it's not getting greens, why is it not working. The reason why your jump shot is not working, it's different reasons why. One of the reasons can be your base. Some of y'all, I've been watching a lot of y'all. Y'all been using some foo-foo bases. Like, these bases been horrible. Like, I literally walk around the park, see myself shooting around. They be using some horrible bases. They go look at one YouTuber video, be like, oh, this base is good. Like, if you want to go look at jump shots, I prefer you go to Agent, Bash Plug. You can hit me up. You can go to Duke. That people that I know that I can trust and rely on these jump shots, that's people, like, I would really rely on, to be honest. Because if you're a play sharp and you don't believe I'm getting greens like this, like, what are you doing? But we're going to be talking about these bases. I'm going to show you the bases that almost everybody in the game uses, the most used bases, the best bases, even with NBA 2K Labs. Go also follow me on Twitter. Follow NBA 2K Labs. This is not a sponsored video. This is not none. I'm dead. I'm literally serious. Go follow them. Go spend that $4.99, $5.99, and work on your jump shots. They give you all the info about your jump shots. But I use Base 11. Base 11. Base 9 are very good. Base 9 is faster than base 11. 11 has a faster going up, but if you want your shot meter to go a little faster, you will use base 9. Also, jump shot 8. If you use jump shot 8, make sure, I'm gonna let you know this now, jump shot 8, you will not get that many greens unless you have an 86 three-pointer mid-range off the dribble. That's the main key. I'm just let you know that you will shoot a lot of full whites. You can use LaMarcus as well. Carmelo is also a good jump shot. If you use Carmelo by itself, it's perfect. Just mess with the speed. You can keep it regular. Rudy Gay, you can change Rudy Gay's speed. It's up to you. The base and the jump shot is good. Kemba Walker, a lot of people sleeps on this base. The reason why people sleep on this base is because not a lot of people use it. I use Kemba Walker. I literally use it at first when I was playing Pro-Am, but I needed a faster base. Also, Kevin Love. Kevin Love, if you're going to be playing park, rec, Pro-Am, any other things like that, I will use Kevin Love as well. But if you want to shoot over people, I will use that base 11, LaMarcus, stuff like that, base 9. Also, Vince Carter is a good base as well. So, a lot of people sleep on Vince Carter. Vince Carter is kind of like Rudy Gay, but it's like a stiffer base, and it's like kind of faster than Rudy Gay. It's not a wind-up. But I'm going to show you the spacing. The next thing is spacing and knowing your shot IQ. The spacing is knowing your shot IQ. Even though I gave him a little space, even though he has takeover, I showed you a clip without takeover and a clip with takeover. He literally still shot over me. And you gotta know your jump shot. I don't want you to be like, oh, I watched this jump shot video, I can't shoot greens. First of all, anybody can get a green in the mic court. That's why I never show you clips of me shooting greens in a mic court. It's too easy. I can just throw my mic court on rookie or pro, whatever it's on, and get greens. Because there's no latency in my career, no latency in my court, unless you're playing against somebody 1v1, 3v3, it doesn't matter. That's when you're going to feel a difference in your jump shot. So, latency, Yes, latency. I know y'all be like, oh, Agent be talking about latency all the time. It's an actual thing. Phantom don't believe it, but it's an actual thing. Sometimes y'all be like, oh, bro, my jump shot feels slow here. Yes, it's a difference between the gameplay, or they just change the game speed sometimes, but it's mostly about latency. Say I'm from the East Coast and I play on the West Coast. My latency is going to be high because I'm not from that server. Even though you got good internet, sometimes you're not going to feel it as bad. But if your internet is not good enough to be playing on different servers, don't do it, bro. Also, like I said, spacing. When you see me in these clips right here, pay attention to the spacing. Pay attention to how the defenders are playing defense on me. Look how my shot IQ compared to literally their defense IQ or their awareness of where I'm at on the floor compared to that. I pull up. I broke his ankles. I know I was going to be open off the ankle breaker. Even if I wasn't off the ankle breaker, I know I had at least enough space. Just a little space on this game can lead to an open shot or a lightly contested. It don't matter if it's open, lightly contested, you have a high chance of going in. It can be a kind of, I ain't going to say heavily, but these lightly contested, they need to put another one here. It was some contested shots be just still going in. But if you pay attention to my shot IQ, that's one thing you have to work on. If you don't have any shot IQ or you have somewhat type of a shot IQ, and you see I have three defenders on me, I could have passed the ball, but I have takeover. I know I can pull this if I hit a little space. And you see, I got a little space. Then my teammate gets the steal. He throws it back to me. I'm open. I literally get open so quick, shoot the ball. So when you pay attention to your shot IQ, you gotta know when you're gonna shoot. Don't overdo what you're doing. Same thing with sharpshooters. Sharpshooters have to have the most shot IQ. Think about it. You can't dribble. Most of them wiggle behind screens. This is a fact. Don't lie. I know some sharpshooters dribble, but when you're going to play twos or threes, they're going to do wraps, overlaps, under baseline cuts to the three-point line or baseline, off-ball screen leading to a three-pointer wrap, things like that. So you have to have shot IQ. You got to know how close a defender is to you. You got to know how much space you have. That's the main key as well, too. So out of those three things, jump shot base, shot IQ, and spacing, that is the main three things you need to work on if your jump shot is not A1. Even if you know you got good shot IQ and you know your spacing, just try to find a new base that fits you and that's good with your game. Like me, base 11 fits my game, like I told you earlier. It fits my game. It's not too slow. It's not too fast. Base 9, if you want a fast jump shot, use base 9. If you want to shoot over people, use base 11, LaMarcus, like I said. Base 8, it's a good mid-range jump shot, but when you want to shoot corner threes, that is not it. I won't want you to use base 8 if you're trying to shoot corner threes and you're a type of player. But I hope you like this video. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe. I hope this helped your jump shot. Hope you improve your shooting. Join the Low Gang. Subscribe. Hit that bell. Follow me on Twitter. Follow me on Twitch. Sub to me on Twitch. And I'm out, y'all. Peace. She wants to go get it. She wants to go.